Welcome to Newland's how-to series of videos. In this episode, we're going to look at how to use the Ground Speed Management 2 feature on T6 Dynamic Command Tractors. Ground Speed Management 2, or GSM2, delivers auto-command CVT-like performance in a power shift tractor. It uses a combination of data relating to engine load, forward speed, and operator settings to manage both the engine and the transmission speed to optimize performance and economy. It's really easy to set up and use, and the video will show you how. To activate GSM, press and hold the second function button and the auto button at the same time. You can also do this by using the IntelliView 4 screen.
The display will change to the GSM2 screen. It now shows two target speed windows, F1 and F2. The two gears shown at the top and bottom are the range of gears available. The bar graph shows the selected speed as a proportion of the maximum speed. The actual speed is always displayed at the bottom, and just above is the requested speed.
On the bottom left of the screen, we can see which of the three GSM modes have been selected: road, field, or PTO. The current gear, the direction of travel, and when the tractor is in reverse, the speed is shown here. To change between F1 and F2, press the second function button and scroll either up or down to change between the target speeds. Using the scroll on its own will increase or decrease the target speed in each range. Pressing the plus or minus button on the command grip handle will change the available gear span. However, before this, the current gear selected must match the gear shown on either the lower or upper end of the gear span indicated on the display. You can also drop down a gear when travelling downhill for increased engine braking. If you wish to adjust the target speed, for example when the target speed is lower than the maximum speed, you can increase the target speed by pushing the command grip forwards. To slow down, simply pull the command grip back until the desired speed is reached. Eco mode is activated when the droop control dial is turned anti-clockwise, and the power mode is activated when turned clockwise. To activate the cruise control feature, select the auto button on the command grip. The cruise control icon will appear in the mode box and at the top of the bar graph. The bar graph will also fill to 100% and the tractor will then reach and maintain the selected speed. To reduce the forward speed whilst driving in manual mode, push the brake pedal until the tractor slows to the desired speed. Once the brake pedal is released, the tractor will stay at the current speed. If you're working in cruise mode, you can either use the brake pedal or pull back on the command grip to slow the tractor. If the brake is applied, the cruise mode will be disengaged and the cruise icon will disappear from the display. Once the brake pedal is released, the tractor will continue to the slowest speed possible and in the lowest gear, just like an auto command CVT transmission. Alternatively, pull back on the command grip, cruise mode is deactivated. To select the PTO mode, engage the PTO. The icon will appear in the mode box to the bottom left of the display. Target speed is no longer the priority, maintaining PTO speed is. Now for demonstration purposes, I'm going to set the required PTO speed using either the hand throttle or the constant engine revs per minute system. I have also set the maximum speed. Now the tractor will try to reach the maximum whilst maintaining constant PTO speed. As a result, when the transmission shifts up and down, engine revs per minute will stay within a selected range to maintain constant PTO speed. Again, droop control can be employed to further tailor the setup. On the left-hand side of the screen, there is a picture of a tractor with an arrow, which indicates the current direction of travel. Below the shuttle icon, there is a current gear icon that shows which gear is selected. When reverse is selected, the bottom box on the right-hand side of the display is labelled R1 and the top R2. These show the maximum speed for each range. Now I'm selecting reverse, and you can see that the current gear is shown at the bottom and the target forward speed is shown at the top.